Symptoms relating to the musculoskeletal system may implicate somatic structures such as connective tissues, but in particular, it is the synovial joints that commonly present symptoms. Also, consider the bones, ligaments, tendons, bursae, articular cartilages, and synovial membranes. Remember, of course, to consider the role of the vascular and nervous systems in any musculoskeletal presentation. Common disorders of these systems include degenerative conditions, trauma, inflammatory, autoimmune, and congenital conditions. A clear understanding of the distinctions between patterns of pain and their different etiologies will help the clinician ask relevant questions for effective differential diagnosis. The patient's primary condition may have a direct musculoskeletal cause or be as a result of a neurological dysfunction. Let us now consider the characteristics and quality of pain from different types of connective tissues. Muscle lesions will produce dull, aching, diffuse, intermittent, or constant pain. If skeletal muscle goes into spasm, it will produce a sudden sharp, tearing-like pain, which is well localized. Ligaments tend to present with a dull ache, producing sharp pain on movement. Tendons and paratendons can produce similar sensations to ligaments, but if inflamed, may produce a deep, dull ache, sharp on movement, and pain on deep pressure. Bone pain may be associated with infection, osteoporosis, or neoplasia, commonly from metastasis. Bone lesions produce deep, boring, nagging pain, usually unremitting or constant, especially at night. Fractures will generate a deep, severe, sharp, and excruciating pain. An arthritic synovial joint will be stiff with reduced range of movement, and it will produce audible or palpable crepitus. The pain tends to ease with movement, but increases with excessive use, and the joint generally stiffens after prolonged rest. In fact, the patient's chief complaint is usually stiffness rather than excessive pain. However, when an arthritic joint is taken to the end of its allowed range of movement, pain, usually sharp, will be reported. Associated muscles are usually stiff and achy. An inflamed synovial joint, such as in rheumatoid arthritis, will be warm and tender to touch, with a feeling of instability when moved. The pain is often described as a constant burning sensation with prolonged morning stiffness. In contrast to connective tissues, peripheral nerve lesions may generate sharp, electric-like pain conforming to peripheral nerve territory with associated neural function disturbances like altered sensation or weakness. Nerve root lesions will also generate sharp, electric shock-like pain, this time conforming to a dermatome with associated neural disturbance. Sympathetic nerve lesions can produce sensations of diffuse burning or stinging quality, often accompanied by secretomotor effects. It needs to be emphasized, however, that these are general guides, and in many instances, the character of pain can vary significantly. With all musculoskeletal presentations, the clinician must consider the possibility of referred pain. When dealing with the musculoskeletal presentation, try to determine at an early stage if the patient is seeking medical help due to pain. If not, is it because of loss of function, deformity, or perhaps for preventative reasons? In a musculoskeletal presentation, the following questions must be considered. Does the patient suffer from joint pain or loss of function? If so, then explore its nature. Is the pain localized to a single joint or more widespread? Are the joints affected swollen, tender, hot, or red? How and when did the symptoms start? Was the onset insidious, or was there a trauma? Were the injuries sustained during sports, at work, or from a road traffic accident. Any history of injuries or fractures, even if they occurred many years ago. Is the patient's condition related to changes in their lifestyle? What aggravates and relieves their symptoms? It may be more valuable to ask the patient to demonstrate rather than describe which particular movements or postures trigger the pain. However, this may not be advisable if the patient is very acute. Is there a daily pattern to the symptoms? Are they worse on waking? And if so, for how long? Or do they get progressively worse as the day goes on? Does the pain wake them up? Are there any associated systemic manifestations like fever, skin rashes, anorexia, weight loss, dry mouth, or eyes? Does the patient suffer from muscle pain, cramps, or weakness? Is the patient complaining of spinal problems? If so, are they complaining of pain, loss of function, or both? Does it affect a particular spinal region or the whole spine? Inquire about the chronicity of their symptoms, including onset, regularity, and progression. Are there any objective neurological manifestations like reflex changes, numbness, or weakness? In addition to spinal symptoms, do they have any other joint problems? Are they suffering from any systemic manifestations? With spinal problems, try to ascertain if you are dealing with a localized mechanical or structural problem or with one of the inflammatory arthritides, and if so, seek for evidence in other parts of the body. Is mobility, work, or exercise affected due to pain, weakness, or loss of function? Does the patient have a family history of joint disease, for example, rheumatoid arthritis or gout? Were they affected by any congenital or developmental problems in childhood, including joint and limb deformities? Musculoskeletal system red flags include symptoms lasting longer than expected for that particular injury. Chronic back pain together with systemic symptoms such as fever, rigors, malaise, and weight loss. Spinal pain together with arthritis, skin rashes, urethral discharge, and abdominal symptoms. Night pain. Constant, unremitting back pain. Bilateral arm or leg pains. Thoracic pain that is persistent or pulsating. Persistent back pain affecting the thoracolumbar region. Unexplained bone pains or fractures. History of cancer. Neurological deficit affecting the saddle area, especially associated with sphincter disturbance. Pain not responding to simple analgesia. Unremitting neurological manifestations, including reflex changes, persistent numbness, and paresthesia. Persistent Horner's syndrome and hoarseness. Unexplained or persistent weakness, whether focal or generalized. Muscle wasting and fasciculations. Prolonged administration of systemic steroids. Unsteadiness or loss of balance. A warm, tender calf muscle. Warm, tender, swollen joints, and fever, especially in a child.